Well, as we know from the experience we're observing in Japan, that sometimes the worst really can happen. And when it comes to nuclear power and the safety of our people, we can never build in enough protections. And frankly, nuclear power is a risky business, and we know that Indian Point is just 25 miles north of New York City, that there it's a 40-year-old plant, that the Nuclear Regulatory Commission has said that it is at the most at-risk nuclear power plant in the United States of America, and I have long called for Indian Point to be closed, but now given what we know today about the risks of the Indian Point location, the lessons from Japan, that sometimes the worst really can happen, and the fact that it would be impossible to evacuate a 25 or 50 mile radius of Indian Point, because it would mean having to evacuate New York City and its suburbs, that it's time to close Indian Point. The governor of New York State has said he wants to close Indian Point. Many of us in the legislature and at the state, at the local level, county legislatures, mayors have argued we need to close Indian Point. Now is the time that we have to get serious. And that means really planning for how we get energy in the absence of having the Indian Point nuclear power plant in Westchester, which provides an estimated 12% of the energy in the downstate area. We can absolutely address it. We need to get more serious about alternative energy plans for the state. We need to get more serious about modernizing our grid so that we can move energy from various areas of the state more quickly and efficiently. Just yesterday, the New York Power Authority finally approved a deal for a new line to run across the Hudson River into Manhattan that will allow New York City to draw more energy from a grid from New Jersey and Pennsylvania and other areas. That's one of the right answers. Expanding solar energy, hydroelectric, alternative energy sources, waste to energy, expanded use of wind power. All of those models have to be taken much more seriously by the state of New York. We need to speed up the process by which we find alternative sources for energy, and we need to plan right now to close Indian Point and decommission it. It can be done by 12-13. That's just a couple of years away. It's the right solution for our state. And again, we're watching what's happening in Japan. It's an international nightmare with radiation leaking out into the land, the food supply, the oceans. We can never let that risk continue in our state. So as a state legislator, I'm committed to making sure that we close Indian Point and find alternative energy resources as fast as possible. But I want to hear from you. Do you think we should close Indian Point? Do you have better alternatives for the state of New York? If you do, I hope you'll go on my website and let me know what you think we ought to be doing. Thank you.